Okay, hello guys, so this is day 5 and in this video I would like to show you and talk to you about two different beaches on the east side of the island that I recommend visiting once you're in Mauritius. So one of them is Belmar Public Beach and the other one is Puerto Lafayette Public Beach. Okay, so let's get into it. So yesterday, after seeing the Caledonian area, we finished the island beach round trip at Grand Gobe, or how I think French pronounce it, Grand Gobe. This was near Amber Island. So since our base is in the Caterpillar area, we had to make our way back to Belmar, which is about 44 kilometers and 1 hour driving time. Easy, right? Just a basic info about Belmar why you guys can have a look at these pictures. Belmar is in the east of the island and belongs to one of the least established tourist areas in the region. The public beach is just outside of the village of the same name. To reach the beach, follow the handwritten signs along the narrow main road, which leads you directly to the beach via a short gravel road. The beach is about 400 meters long, and on arrival here you will be impressed by the deep blue water, palm trees and the shiny white sand. The phyllo trees at the car park and along the rest of the beach provide shade for the whole area. Especially at weekends, many local families come here for a picnic, and during the week many fishermen drop anchor here. You will also see some tourists wandering from one resort to the other, but otherwise you are usually undisturbed and can enjoy the fantastic view here. This beach is great for relaxing. There are no restaurants or water sports outlets at this beach. However, you will find water sports offering at the two neighboring resorts to each side of the beach. Directly at the beach you will only see small fishing boats bobbing up and down in the sea, and all other kinds of water sports activities such as surfing, kiting or diving. Alright, so after spending a couple of hours on this beach, we were on our way to Puerto Lafayette Public Beach. This journey costed us 10.5 kilometers and only 40 minutes driving time.
This is the second stop. Really nice rocky area. Locals are here. It's Sunday, late afternoon. This place is amazing, like a volcanic zone. And everybody just chilling and watching the water. It's a really cool place. I really recommend to visit once you're here. The composition together with the black rocks and the wild water is just amazing. It's a black and white game in the natural way.
Okay, so Puerto Lafayette Public Beach, located at the northeast portion of the island. And you can already tell that here we got some dark volcanic rock formations, especially at the higher end of the main beach area. You can reach this spot from the main road B15. In my opinion, it's an excellent place to spend some time here, especially before sunset. Just watching the waves, sit down, relax, followed by a good dinner nearby. As an endpoint of the day. Cool spot. This corner of Mauritius that can be very windy, perfect for kitesurfing. The wild beauty and big waves makes Puerto Lafayette Beach a place not suitable for children and inexperienced swimmers. With the exception of few kilometers of beautiful white beach, Post Lafayette is a beach with rustic landscape. Surrounded by unspoiled nature, this place is still untouched by masterism. The wild and rustic side of that beach gives it an undeniable charm, a magical moment for lovers of nature who visit this place. A secluded beach with rouge seas, this part of Mauritius does not attract the crowds. The volcanic rocks is present over much of the beach. Mangroves and coral reefs rich in marine life will be the most beautiful part of this authentic beach. Post Lafayette Beach is still a place to visit, but be careful while swimming in this rouge sea. Some of the activities of this area are pedalo, windsurfing, kitesurfing and kayaking. Alright, so this seems to be it for the fifth episode, even though this was only two spots of this great little island, but I truly think that they are unique and special and absolutely worth checking them out. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, consider subscribing if you haven't already, and see you in the next one.